I did a movie with Christopher Walken called Suicide Kings. First day of the movie, Christopher Walken's facing the house we're filming in. He's alone. I walk up behind him, and without turning around, he goes, "That must be Jay Mars coming towards me." Yeah. Then he turns around and goes, "Oh, I'm right again. I'm with my dog." And he goes, "What happened to your dog's tail? Where did it go?" I had a Rottweiler with no tail. That's right. "What happened to your dog's tail? Where did it go?" I'm just standing there thinking, like, where the fuck did my dog's tail go? This is all true, he gets really close to my face, looks over both of his shoulders, like he's about to tell a black joke at work. And he whispers to me, "It would be great to have a tail." I look at him still and I go, "Why?" He goes, "Come on, if you had a tail, everyone would know. If you were angry or upset, they'd see you coming down the block. They'd say, 'Whoa, get back. Look at his tail, he's crazy.'" Then he looks at me like it's my turn to talk. We haven't said hello yet. I have no idea what to say. I said the first thing that came to my mind. You know what that was? I said to Christopher Walken, Academy Award winning actor, "Would you rather be able to fly or have a tail?" Right after that, out loud, you could barely hear it, but I said it. I went, "Oh no." I could have asked him anything. He won an Oscar for The Deer Hunter. He's immortal. He's in the history books. That's a made man. I could have asked him, "How do you learn all your lines? Hey, how do you cry on camera? Like, that's hard, right? What's De Niro like?" I didn't ask him any of that shit. My moment alone, I decided to ask the Academy Award winner, "Would you rather be able to fly or have a tail?" Christopher Walken, hand to God, looks at me and goes, "I'm so glad you asked me that." Finally, a tail, of course. You could always get on an airplane with your tail. Clint Eastwood directed this movie I was in that none of you saw, called Finger My Sister. No. Let's see if you're still paying attention. Hereafter, this movie, it was a pretty good movie. I had a real small part, it was neat. I played Matt Damon's brother. Richard Kind's in it, Clint Eastwood's directing it. It's fascinating to work with Clint Eastwood. We're shooting in a sports bar. We're done shooting for the day, and behind me, I hear Clint Eastwood go, "JJ, would you like to join me for a Czechoslovakian beer?" That's the most random and specific shit at the same time ever. It's Clint Eastwood. "Would you like to join me for a Czechoslovakian beer?" I go, "No, I don't drink. I'm an AA." And he goes, "Well, then I guess you're done for the day." And that's how he said it too. Like, "You're a fucking faggot. Get away from me." Like, yikes. Easy, Clint. It's a different time. I'm in my hotel room that night actually thinking I was fired because I wouldn't drink with Clint Eastwood. It was uncomfortable. And I'm laying in bed like, why wouldn't you just drink with the guy? Fall off the wagon, it's fucking Clint Eastwood. Drink with him, do coke off his dick, who cares? The things that could have happened, I'll be in his house, he'd be like, "You're the only one that understands me. Come on, let's do some more." I get to play Chet Baker. I get to play George Carlin. I get to do some cool Vietnam movie and say, "You want square around?" I get to say cool shit. But no, I threw it all out the window because I'm in AA. Guess you're done for the day. I go to work the next morning. I'm not sure if I have a job, by the way. I'm standing outside an apartment building where we're gonna shoot. It's me, Matt Damon, Richard Kind. There's a boom mic guy standing there, a producer, and Clint Eastwood pulls up in a town car, walks across the street, doesn't even fucking look both ways. It's Clint Eastwood. Cars are just locking up their brakes like, holy shit. Can you imagine just driving on Geary Avenue in like San Francisco and like Clint Eastwood just steps in front of your car like, oh my God. No one's gonna believe us. He starts yelling from across the street, JJ, how long has it been since you've had drugs or booze in your body? I'm like, oh, first of all, in my mind, I'm like, I'm not this interesting. This is really weird. He slept on this shit and came back? He really wanted a Czechoslovakian beer. Maybe I could have done coke off his dick. Jesus. I go, May 5th, 1998. And he goes, my problem was never booze or drugs. Are you wearing a microphone right now? Yes, I am. It's a movie. You guys have been to the movies, right? Did you hear it? Everyone's wearing a microphone. I'm wearing one now. It's fucking insane. I go, yes, I am wearing one, sir. And he goes, cover it up. I put my hand over my microphone. It's up on my collar. But meanwhile, Matt Damon's wearing a live mic. So is Richard Kind. The boom guy goes from up here to down here and starts scooching closer. Spill it, old man, spill it. Clint Eastwood said to me, JJ, my problem was never booze or drugs. My problem was always P-U-S-S-Y. You guys go do the scene whenever you're ready. Now I have to go act, know that Clint Eastwood is a pussy addict.